When feeling joyful about something leads to being vulnerable. Global Goddess Gatherer at Goddess on Purpose, and today's video about vulnerability is sort of it's probably a weird type of topic today. And the reason is I'm sitting here in the Sunshine Coast, my tracky pants, like looking daggy, after just speaking to 23 women here for the Enlightened Goddesses networking event. And talking about life purpose and goddesses in the hands, gift markings in the hands. And I spoke today for about an hour and 20. And I haven't done that for quite a while since, for a little while anyway, as I'm navigating coming back out into the world in a bigger way, with a slightly different message, and trying that on and seeing the vulnerability in that, how it will be received, and being really mindful of how I can communicate that. And it was amazing. Like, today was so amazing. These women were fantastic. Kelly Beverly, who is the who runs Enlightened Goddess Networks, they have these every month, and I've been a long friend of hers, and she invited me up here. So coming from Melbourne up here and spending the time with her, I'm feeling quite shattered actually, because when two women get together, we talk, and there's been a lot of sharing and being vulnerable in that sharing of deep feelings and on this journey of healing. Anyway, I digress. The vulnerable part of this video and getting up there and just getting back into the flow of things and really embodying what my message is about, and then sharing that with these amazing women sitting there in this receptive mode. And it's like, okay, here I am, here is my vision, here is what my message is, and not giving, not worrying about what they think or how they would take that on or what might be triggered. I don't know. I was just sharing from the heart and got a bit passionate sometimes. And I mean, all in all, I think it was received really well, but you still don't know. And putting yourself in that space of, God, are they going to even like this work? Are they going to like me? Are they going to understand it? Is it too much? Because, you know, I'm a bit of a oversharer. Sometimes I spew too much information and the eyes glaze over. And so being vulnerable in that, I feel really grateful, really, really grateful that I got to share this space with them. And you know, a couple of years ago, I would be like stressing about it. Did I get the content right? Did I wear the right outfit? I certainly didn't wear tracky pants, but there's the three faces of the goddess, right? So just getting up there and sharing from my heart space. And some little things, you know, some things the story. And each time I talk about my story and how I got onto this path, I feel, you know, something deepens in me, and you know, I shared today that I was nearly killed in a car accident and how I've just brushed over that and being grateful to be here. You know, I wrote three cars off, just missed a truck, blah, blah, and how I can just go, that didn't really matter. Well, yeah, it does matter. It is part of your journey, and we all have stories, you know. And I'm sort of feeling quite shattered right now, but in such a great way of, here I am, here it is, thank you. And I'm not I don't want to say take it or leave it, because I don't feel that way. I'm just feeling really gratitude and vulnerable and being broken open just a little bit more today by being in the presence of these divine feminine women. So that's my share today, and I hope you get something from that, which you can decide what that would be. So thank you so much. Subscribe to the YouTube here, or put some comments below. I'm really really grateful that you are watching these, and stay tuned for the next one. Okay, many blessings. Bye for now. Thank you.